Lord Jesus. Thank you, mighty Jesus. Thank you, precious Father. Be thou exalted, be thou glorified. Let no one live the same. Bible says in Psalm 65, verse 2. I've read this psalm before. Just give it to my spirit to read again. Psalm 65, verse 2. O thou that hearest prayer, God hears. I read it before. If you didn't write it down, write it down again. Write it down. Let it enter your spirit. O thou that hearest prayer. So God hears prayer. Psalm 65, verse 2. O thou that hearest prayer. So God hears prayer. So you don't pray in vain. I'm serious, you don't pray in vain. Nobody prays in vain. O thou that hearest prayer. Say, unto thee shall all flesh come. Zabra gadu shapapaya. All flesh have gathered, everyone has gathered unto him. Amen. Shall all flesh gather. Tonight, you not live the same. Yeah. Why? Because God hears prayer. Yeah. And we are gathered unto him. Unto him alone, not to unto any man. Yes. We're not here to watch movie. We're here to seek the face of the Lord. Yes. Left to, if I'm to watch movie, I'll be at home sleeping. Yes. I'm here for a purpose. In fact, I was feeling sleepy. So I'd rather go and sleep on my bed than come here. But I came here unto him that heareth prayer. Yes. And I know that before I leave here, God will answer me. Yes. God will answer you. Yes. God will answer us. Yes. In the name of Jesus. I say you won't live here the same. I prophesy you will not live here the same. In the mighty name of Jesus. The mortals will visit you. The mortals will visit you. In the name of Jesus. A result will come to you because you will mix this with faith. You mix this with faith. You mix this word tonight with faith. And it will produce profit. I say you will profit. You will profit. You will profit. In the name of Jesus. Every businessman wants profit, not loss. And God is a businessman. Amen. He wants profit tonight. And I declare we live the same in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, clap for Jesus. Thank you, precious Father. Be exalted, be glorified. Okay, I'm going to be fast because of time. First of all, some house clearing. By the grace of God, this week is going to be very busy for all of us. By the grace of God, as usual. We have 3-day dry fast every month. It has come again. It's only a matter of time. It comes back again. Praise God. But I want to see this as an opportunity, not as a burden. Please, I beg you. If you see this as a burden, please don't even try. Don't even come in. Once you start feeling this, it has come again. Please don't do it. Just forget about it because it's not going to work. But if you're excited to see come as an opportunity to go to this God that hears prayer, Kalabaya, then you're welcome on board. Am I communicating?
Yes,
you know, life is in phases. There are certain issues we dealt with last month, we ate another phase again.
Yes.
Just as the way men are in sizes. Amen? So life is in phases. That's how it is. That's just life. Sorry, I mean, if it offends you, sorry. That's just life. Life is in phases. Men are in sizes too. Even clothes you wear in sizes too. So everything is size, everything is faces. So it will come again. After I finish September, it will come in October again. I mean, yeah, that's it. November and for it, January will do our 6-7 days. So it's gonna come. Praise the Lord. So just say, tell yourself, I'm settled for this for life. Men that live a fasted life, they knew it will come and they are ready. Amen. It doesn't come as a surprise. Praise the Lord. So we begin on Tuesday by the grace of God, and we'll be here for our first initial mountain encounter. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and then Friday, Saturday will be our Night of Supernatural, as usual, making 5 days. Amen. It's on the internet right now. Boosted it, so I know a lot of people are seeing it already. They're going to have 5 days mega fire marathon. It will be awesome. So on Tuesday, we'll be here by 7 p.m. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Rosary prayer will start by 7, and then 7 p.m. 7, we start Rosary by 7. It has started. And then don't forget about prayer of 6 a.m., 6:30 a.m., 6:30 p.m., 3:30 p.m., and then 6:30 p.m. So this is our routine for the prayers. Amen. 3 days of dry fast and prayer. So there's no eating, there's no drinking. Praise God. It's 72 hours fasting and prayer. Amen. So welcome you all to this mountain encounter. You will not live here the same in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, by the grace of God, we have been dealing with the series of amen, understanding the force of divine alignment. And we began the series first Saturday of this month. Today is a part 3. We have part 1, part 2, 3. Part 1, we looked into crisis. And part 2, we talked about, what was it, part 2 last week? What was it?
Constraint.
God bless you, man. And tonight, we're looking at very important topic. Very important, and I need to pay attention. At time, I don't permit to finish it, but whatever I stop, God will help me. Amen. Time is really going already. So I'm going to start real quick. I'll be fast because of time. I'm going to tag this topic tonight. Now, today we have team, but we have topics every week. I'm going to tag this team, the closed womb. The closed womb. Sorry, the closed womb. Amen? The closed womb. Womb. Amen? Womb. Like human womb. Amen? The closed womb. Amen? And I want to take my reflection today in the anchor scripture from 1 Samuel. Chapter 1. I want us to read. Isn't it in the house? Eh? Yes, so I want us to read from verse 5 to. Okay.
And the Lord had closed her womb.
Mm.
And because the Lord had closed her womb, her rival kept provoking her in order to irritate her. This went on year after year. Whenever Hannah went up to the house of the Lord, her rival provoked her till she wept and would not eat.
Mm.
Elkanah, her husband, would say to her, Hannah, why are you weeping? Why don't you eat? Why are you downhearted? Don't I mean more to you than 10 sons?
Mm.
Once, when they had finished eating and drinking in Shiloh, Hannah stood up. Now Eli the priest was sitting on a chair by the doorpost of the Lord's temple. In bitterness of soul, Hannah wept much and prayed to the Lord. And she made a vow, saying, Oh, Lord Almighty, if you will only look upon your servant's misery and remember me, and not forget your servant, but give her a son, then I will give him to the Lord for all the days of his life, and no razor will ever be used on his head. Mm. And as she kept on praying to the Lord, Eli observed her mouth. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Okay, read 13. You read 13.
Hannah was praying in her heart, and her lips were moving, but her voice was not heard. Eli thought she was drunk.
Mm. Hallelujah. Physically, when we refer to womb, women, they already know what womb is all about. Amen. That the womb is a gift from God that God has given to women. It's a womb. That, I want to let you know, some of us men who don't know, that womb is different from stomach. You know, before I used to think that stomach is womb is stomach. For real, I used to be in that ignorance until I came of age. I know that womb is different from stomach, and that position differs. Womb is only meant for the baby. Stomach is meant for food. Men, in case you don't know it now. You wonder where is your baby being produced? Where is it coming from? It's from the womb, not for the stomach. Praise the Lord. So, and God has specially designed the womb for a purpose. Number one, the womb is made in such a way to receive. To receive. I'm talking physically now. I'll go to spiritual now. I want to finish it. Now, the womb is meant to receive the seed of a man. Now, number two, the womb is meant to produce egg to meet with the seed, to create conception. So, reception, conception. Number three, women, please, I'm making mistake. Please, draw me back. Number three, They won't be now. It comes out. Praise God. So the womb also serves as a delivery process through which delivery channel, through which the baby is, you know, comes out to the world. And one thing I notice is that before the baby comes out, most of the time, except now we have people taking what do you call that? You take in your womb, they make it just before you, women have to you have to push hard until the baby comes out. Amen. That's a process. Anyway, I'm not going to that. Now, but my interest is that baby comes out, the baby must make a sound. Am I right?
Yes.
Baby must make a sound. And I say, yes, baby has arrived. And the joy is everywhere. The baby has arrived. No matter what you have done in the womb, if baby comes out without making crying, then everybody's in trouble. Yeah, they flog it, baby. But they flog baby and doesn't make sound, everybody's in trouble. You see doctors and nurses running test kit, bring this, bring that. What do you call that? Assumption, whatever you call it. Everybody's in trouble. Amen. Beat the baby, do it everywhere. So but the baby comes out and begin to make that sound. The first thing the baby does is to make sound and cry. That cry is a sound. Now that was saying the word have come. And the word will say, the word, wow. And the word will say, welcome, baby, into this world. Come and see what we are seeing. But we said, no, if the mother is a Christian, you would have told the baby, look, you are coming to come out and speak from the volume of the book.
Amen.
Which the mother has been speaking unto the baby before the baby come out. But if you're not a Christian, you'll be talking rubbish. Will the baby come out? The baby die? Will the baby become? Oh, the baby become? No, for a child of God, you are speaking already. You already determined the destiny of the baby from the womb. So when she's coming out, she's coming out into manifestation.
Amen.
Am I communicating?
Yes.
So the sound the baby need to make is very important to prove that the baby is alive. Is that true?
Yes.
Okay. Now, having understood that, let's now go to spiritual realm again. Now, Jesus said something very clearly. He said, out of their belly shall flow rivers, which means Christians have spiritual bellies. So it's not just physical bellies. We also have spiritual what? Bellies. So just stomach, spiritual wombs. And then the same thing physical womb does, that's what a spiritual womb also does. Praise God. That's why when somebody is preaching or you're reading the Bible or you're incubating, fasting, whatever you're doing, you need to study the word, because the word is a seed. Not like a man has a seed. The word is a seed. So you don't, in the womb, in the spiritual womb of a Christian, you need to receive seed. So when I hear people say, pray, don't preach or don't preach too much, pray, just keep praying. No, you're missing something. That means don't want to be pregnant. Have you heard when a man marries the woman and say, don't worry, let's just be going to parties and this world, let's just be going. Have you heard that before? The woman will ask you, come, sir, why did you marry me? He come bring the table up. I said, why did you marry me? To be going about for parties, wearing the Gilead. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You must look for seed. You must receive. Woman is ready for seed. Before a woman will marry, she wants to get the seed. Am I communicating? So before you to have an encounter, to come to conception with Jesus, with the Holy Ghost, with power, with forces, you know, that takes you beyond the natural, you need to be ready to receive the seed. And Bible says the word is a seed. Well, some fall in the wrong place, while some in the good place. So if your spirit man is belly is ready, womb is ready to receive the word, you're going to follow your fertile ground. I declare,
amen.
Your heart, your spirit is a fertile ground for the word.
Amen.
Tonight it will enter you and fertilize.
Amen.
I declare you are ready to receive the seed.
Amen.
The word of God will come into you and you conceive. Just the way a Christian womb conceives, you conceive. To conceive something. Friends, you don't come to fellowship and live the same, because you are come to receive the seed of the word. And before you leave here, you'll be pregnant.
Amen.
Ah, my God, babalagada. I say you'll be pregnant. In fact, some of you will deliver right away before you leave. In the name of Jesus, it's a mystery. For a natural world, it takes 9 months to come to delivery. But in spiritual realm, it does not have to take 9 months. For some of us, the way heavens count 9 months is not the way we count 9 months. Am I communicating?
Yes.
So you can conceive now and deliver now.
Amen.
Am I communicating? Yes. By the time you leave here, your baby will start crying.
Yes.
That thing you carry will start crying for manifestation.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
So the womb, spiritual womb, also receive the seed. And then when there is an encounter, you are set to conceive the seed. That's why when you come to fellowship or you are listening online, if you are busy cooking and moving here and there, you put your phone on mute, you might not have, you might receive it, but there might be conception. Because you're going to fall on non-fertile ground. Am I communicating? So those of you who are online, listen to me. For you to have the word, just like a woman who wants to have the seed enter and then meet the egg, the same way, that's what you call an encounter, realm of the spirit. When the seed meets your spirit, that's a conception. That's an encounter. It's called an encounter. But whereby the seed comes in and finds the egg, you can't find it. The egg means attention, focus. That's egg. So it is, oh, word of God comes into your spirit, mind doesn't find the egg, doesn't find everything it needs, necessary environment to thrive, it dies. Or it goes away. Or he enters one, enters the other, go the other way. Praise the Lord. And then he asks you, what happened? It was powerful. I mean, there was no conception. He just had miscarriage. Am I communicating? May God deliver you from miscarriage. May God deliver you from miscarriage. That's what I call supernatural miscarriage. That when Holy Ghost is trying to conceive you in your womb, spiritual womb, you are not ready. The egg is not produced. You're not paying attention. So when it comes in, nothing is happening. It just goes away. May it not be your portion in Jesus' name. That's why you have to pay attention to God's word. Don't be distracted. Because why people don't receive miracles? Because there's no conception. There must be what conception? Inside of your spiritual stomach. Am I communicating? So conception takes in there. And then it doesn't just stop there. As soon as conception comes in, the spiritual womb is ready to incubate, to brood, as a hen boots over the chicks. That's where people have problems. Say, I've been hearing God's word for a long time now. Why is something not happening? You're not brooding. You're not incubating it. You just hear it and it goes away. There's no structure to incubate. The womb is not meant to just receive. It's meant to also incubate it. Or else, maybe you have miscarriage. So that's why you need to pay attention. Taking the word of God like into your spiritual stomach and pay attention. Make sure you receive it and let it dwell and settle on your spirit man, on your spiritual belly. Am I communicating? By so doing, you're incubating. Sometimes you might even hear the scripture. You don't understand it. You just know what? I'm going to, let me study this. When I get home, you continue. You see, fellowship does not just end here. When you get home, the scripture we're using here, go and look at it. That's incubation. Incubation moment. You're incubating it. Because it has not yet formed properly. You are still looking at the scripture. The Bible says, he himself took my families and bore my sicknesses. How does it happen? How will it happen? How can God take my pain? You know, to you, it has not settled well. But you go home and begin to incubate on it, brood over it. Am I going to get it? Hover around the world, begin to look at it. How does this thing work? How does this thing work? All of a sudden, boom, enters you. Say, yeah, I got it. Amen. Am I communicating? That's incubation. That's incubating on the word. That's why some people, before they don't, because they don't incubate, they carry miscarriage before incubation. That's miscarriage, spiritual miscarriage. But if you incubate very well and the word now be settled properly, because incubation makes it to settle very well in your spirit until God's word settles, it might not produce profit. This week we're talking about profit. Until it settles, it might not produce any profit. So it comes and goes, doesn't settle. May not be a portion in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Incubation. Shout incubation.
Incubation.
Amen. So when it settles, then it begins to develop leg, eye, brain. This and that. I don't know the process anyway. A leg is the head that starts first, or whatever it is. It begins to go to eye, nose, whatever it is. It goes down. So whatever that forms, every part of the body begins to form, develop, everything begins to come into alignment. Praise God. Shout alignment.
Alignment.
You know, come into proper alignments, everything comes, that development. And it just end there. You need to nurture the word. To nurture it. God told Ezekiah, prophesy, son of man. How does a prophesy with when the bones have not come together? So bones have to come together. Joints. No? Am I communicating? That's why you're hearing sound. They are coming together. Sounds. Kalabaya. Zebragado Shababa. He's hearing crack, the bones are coming together, tendon to tendon. No, things are just coming together. Before you prophesy, they must come together. Am I communicating? So, before you prophesy, they don't come together, you are just speaking. I mean, just speaking whatever you want to speak. Add the word. Bible calls it add the words. Amen. Before you speak solid word that will bring life, they must not be idle words. They must be word backed with logos. Am I communicating? They must be word they have settled in your spirit man. They have come together. They have settled. They have incubated on them. You are speaking it. And I told the ways of the patriarchs. That's how they spoke. They for years they've been incubating what they will say to their children. For one day, just speak it out. You'll be saying, oh, man, they just said it. No, they've been incubating on it, waiting on the Lord on it. I can't tell somebody, I will give you corn and give you wine. Is that how we heard it? My father will give me corn and give me wine. What is corn and what is wine? But these two things made their generation, made their children. Corn and wine. Am I communicating? It sounds very simple, but they've been bitten on corn and wine for years until now release it. They come to delivery. I declare for you, today is your delivery moment. It's your delivery moment. Guess you're not pregnant yet, you'll be pregnant today. And you shall deliver today. In the name of Jesus. You know, we deliver in the place of prayer. That's why we come and bring ourselves to delivery. The place of prayer. That's why after the word, you pray to bring it to delivery. Am I communicating? But if you pray, it doesn't come to delivery, you don't profit, then you need to incubate more so it can come to delivery. Am I communicating? Am I communicating? Zubra katali brekete, makoto libragata pababa. Shata, we come to delivery. In Jesus' mighty name. So you now not sure the inability to. A time comes when the world is not ready. The seed is ready, fully developed, fully nurtured, and is ready to shoot out to your canals. Hala baba ba, sukataya. Shoot out to your canals. And what is your canal? In the realm, the physical canal is the woman's canal, but in the realm of the spirit, your canal is your mouth. Abracadabra. You are ready to shoot it out like a shooting star. Ready to move it out like a tornado. Palakata, lakata, lakata. Lebrakata, we are kabashing. You are releasing some delivery. Sakalabaya. In the realm of the spirit. The mortals are controlling some things. Bible says, when they speak, they speak at mistress. Kalabaya. Makutuli babaya. Palababaya. Hey, my father. Nakotuli bragada. Zubrekete babaya. Ah. How big is this big mistress? Friends, this word is ruled by mistress. Number one, the word is ruled by thrones. The thrones. Dominions. Secondly, the word is ruled by mistress. Not by principles. Principle might be the last thing. But before you talk about principles, you talk about dominions. Thrones and powers. Then mysteries follow. One of the mysteries of this word is words. To a kind of man, words is like you are wasting your time. But the spiritual man, word is powerful. You can build on a word for years. The day you speak it out, it's already incubated. And it has come to the delivery point. You will not have miscarriage. You will not have miscarriage. You will not have miscarriage. You will have profit. You will profit from what you have waited for. In the name of Jesus. Shout out, we profit. Shabrakotoli balagade. Can I go deeper? Lebra, go deeper to go higher. Makotoli baba. Let's go to the book of Samuel we just read now. The life of Hannah was a mystery. Shaba, Lord, help me to preach this. Help me, Lord, help me, Lord. Zubra katabaya. Oh my God, where I start from? Bible says in verse 6, Sheba kutaba. And her adversary also provoked her soul for to make her fret because the Lord has shut her wounds. The mistress of closed wounds. Ladies and gentlemen, yes, we know that sometimes God might do certain things in your life for certain reasons. You see, wicked people will do certain things to you, not to kill you. But God will allow certain things not to make you better. God shut her wounds. Not that she was barren. God shut it for a purpose. Ladies and gentlemen, if your circumstances, things you find yourself around you, are not working properly, you try to have children, it's not working. That's a misnomer, of course. You try to become proclaimed to prosper, it's not working. That's a misnomer, of course. You try to move forward, it's not, we are moving forward. That's a misnomer, of course. You try to do things, not working. That means things are shutting down, or things have been shut down for a purpose. Friends, the bigger your pregnancy produces, the closer to your delivery. Sometimes you suffer many things physically because your delivery is at hand. Am I communicating? See a woman who is already bent this way, about to come to better. She cannot hardly do things. Her husband will help her to take her leg up, help her to take food. She can't even climb a staircase because she's close to delivery point. Am I communicating? If things are hard for you, know that your delivery point is close. Just know that my delivery point is close, not ordinary. Am I communicating? God shut her womb. Listen to this. But God didn't shut her mouth. Can I preach tonight? Listen, gentlemen. God
heart. But God did not shut her mouth. Friends, the Bible says for 10 years Hannah was barren, could not give birth. God shut her womb 10 years. So I'm sorry, history, not Bible. I will go through the history of Hannah. Why she was not pregnant, how many years it took her? 10 years, 30 years. And in Jewish custom, if your wife is not giving birth for 10 years, you are allowed to marry a second wife. That's why you cannot marry a second wife. Not because you wanted to do that. As a matter of fact, history has it that Hannah was the one that told the husband to marry a second wife. According to Jewish tradition, just the way Sarah told the husband to do certain things. Am I communicating? This happened. So that's what happened to Hannah. And then, knowing, thinking that when the woman comes in, things will come better. Brother, she was bringing in a force of alignment. Kali Bragado Sakata. Mako Toli Babaya. So Katali Brigade. Bring in some force. Hayagada. Friends, Akali Bragada. Oh, let's start this. This is too much for me. I don't want to. That's what I'm not even finishing today. Just my body is just shaking. Am I communicating? How can a man bring in a force that will begin to become rival to him? Not knowing the realm of the spirit, that person is a force that will bring alignment. Am I communicating? There might be some things you are going through in your family right now. You think, God, where are you? Why am I going through these troubles of life? Why are things happening like this in my working place? Why is my husband treating me like this? Why is my heart this way? God is just permitting a force of alignment. It might look difficult to you, but God is just beginning to walk. Am I communicating? Friends, for 10 good years, God was waiting on Hannah. Jabragado. Hiya, Baba. God would not have for 10 years to say something. Right now, we read from the scripture that Hannah was vexed, was troubled, was depressed. She could not speak. She was getting into rivalry with her rival. The history says that this woman purposely we insult her every day. That's history. In fact, when I go through it, he said that the woman was a bully. That's how the said is a bully. Because she would insult this woman every day. Look at you, childless woman being. Look at you. Meanwhile, Hannah was what I brought you in. According to Jewish tradition. And she didn't do anything wrong. No. But she brought somebody. Not only that, somebody is having somebody. Am I communicating? What you are going through is not ordinary. It's just a force after your life to bring to the place of your destiny. Am I communicating? Hannah bullied that to her destiny. Hannah insulted that. Penina. Okay, I call it Penina. Penina. It's the year. Penina. Okay, Penina. Penina insulted her. Sorry, Father. Insulted her to her destiny, to the place of her assignment. Am I communicating? Do you know what it means to carry a prophet and produce a prophet? Friends, people that have greater destiny, they go through greater troubles. Am I communicating? Because our great destinies are greater. So God takes them to greater troubles. The moment God announced to Mary, Emily, Mary, you are highly favored, her trouble began. Baba. So be careful when God announces your favor. I will go to the meaning of Hannah. Hannah means graciousness, favor. When God announces you as a favor, be careful. You are about to enter troubles. I call it divine trouble, holy trouble. Not because not the one that will kill you, but the one that will make you better. Because you have a prophet ahead of time. Am I? You think it will be easy? Devil knows that you carry prophet. You carry something very major. Whom raises up, not touch his hair. That's a special ministry. Carry a prophet, not just a prophet, that raises up, will not touch his hair. That's a deeper mystery. To produce a Nazarene. That's a deeper ministration. Am I communicating? To carry such a person in your womb, you will not find it funny. You won't find it easy because you're about to produce something that will cause a major change in the world. That will create a major dispensation in the world. Therefore, be ready to carry trouble. Jesus said, be of good cheer, overcome the world. He said, the world will bring trouble for you. But don't worry, I'm in charge. I am praying for you. I declare for you, you will not have miscarriage. You will not have miscarriage. You will not have miscarriage. You will come and put to bed. Safely, you will safely land. Your children will land safely. Your children will land safely. Your destiny will land safely. In the name of Jesus, shout, I hear you well. For we serve the true and living God. Who is the same yesterday, the same today, the same. forevermore. If God had gone into Elkanah, had gone into Hannah, it's your turn. I say it's your turn. I say it's your turn. I say it's your turn. Shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hey. You're waiting on God for 10 years? God said, I'm waiting for you. Friends, can I give an announcement? Towards the time of 10 years, my father, you know, they represent the government of heaven. Towards the time of 10 years, we represent government of heaven. Heaven said, no, when you are trying to cross a boundary without producing the prophet of our generation, you are about to go over 10 years. The government of heaven intervened. And the wicked Penina, what his name is, and begin to inject her into more bully. Bully her the more. She refused to talk. Bully her the more. Curse her the more. Insult her the more. Kick her the more. That she will come to her senses. That door has shut your womb, but your mouth is not shut. Am I communicating? It's time to talk. Tell three persons, it's time to talk.
Jesus, hallelujah, Abunania, Chayamiri, hallelujah, Wakosarano Kosaraya, hallelujah, Abunania, Chayamiri, hallelujah.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Bible says that year after year they will go to Shiloh. Shiloh means God's gift. How can you go to the place of God's giftings and come back the same? You won't go and carry children from Shiloh, God's gift. You go and come back barren. But Hannah was forced to go because it was tradition. She must go because she will go to Shiloh with annoyance, with vexation, with trouble, because the rival will not let her be. She will just go to Shiloh just to be sick, to obey Elkanah. But she was vexed and depressed. Hannah suffered depression. Deep-seated depression because Penina will not let her be every day. But 10 years for the government of heaven say no, enough is enough. This woman was bullied to start talking. Shakatabaya. Friends, those people we call bullies, that is actually your destiny helpers. They're helping to produce something. Am I communicating? That ayagada lagada lagada lagada. Hey, shakata la bragado shakete. Makotoli bragada. Am I communicating? Ah! Ladies and gentlemen, that is a day. Monkey go go market, he won't come back. Am I communicating? This very day, this bully daddy more. And I say, how will I be eating again? I am tired of eating. The Bible says in verse 6, and her adversary before, the Bible says, an adversary also. It means that it wasn't happening before. The Bible says also in verse 6, provoked her. In case Penina thought she was pushing her to annoy her, but God turned around to make something happen. So her provocation was to push Anna to cause something to happen, to cause a change. And for the first time, woman said, I'm tired of getting sorrowful. Tired of getting bullied, and let woman go with it. Something must happen. It's either it happened or I die. If I perish, let me perish. And that year was the last year. Kalabaya. Ladies and gentlemen, it's possible that Hannah has been speaking, but not speaking the right words. Why are you bullying me? That's words, right? Am I the only one with this word? And there are other people who are barren. Am I the only one who is barren? Every time, barren, which can't be this? Am I the only one who is barren? Hey, look at Mrs. Jacob. Sorry, I'm not talking. Mrs. Mrs. Akoro. I'm Mrs. Akoro. It's barren. Akoro. Look at Mrs. Bangwa. It's barren. Hey, am I the only one? Hey, it's barren, is it? Hey, am I the one? I have produced children. I'm Mrs. Body. I don't know why you like to use the body too much. Am I the only one? Am I the only one? You're bullying me. My God is seeing you. My God is seeing you. My God will punish you. He's seeing you.
sorry, that's the Bible. History has that at this time that the rival had 12 children.
Wow.
In 10 years. I don't know how it happened. Whether it's 10 years, I don't know. Whether it's 10 years, I don't know how it happened. No. Anyway, let me just say 10 years. Let me say it could be whatever. You know, whatever it is, where you can't produce children. I don't know how it happened. Maybe he had twins, I don't know. Anyway, history, I don't know, but that's what she said. So she had 10 sons and 2 daughters. Am I communicating? At this point, that means the woman has produced 12 disciples. Heaven say, ah! This one is meant to produce my Samuel. Something must happen. And said, this Shiloh she has come is the final.
Amen.
But friends, God do not just push things by himself. He will push you to push. Friends, nothing just happens. Nothing just, you know, I've told you before. Why God does that? I've told you before, right?
But
not before.
Yes,
nothing just happens because God has given man legality because of this. To take, he said, heavens is the place of God and earth has given the sons of men. So we own this place. So God will not just intervene to the realm of mortals without seeking your permission. Am I communicating?
Yeah.
So God will not just say, okay, because when it doesn't happen normally, it's a misnomer. That means you need provocation. Am I communicating? Mm-hmm. When people marry, normally you should have children, right? Okay, if it doesn't happen, that's a misnomer. That means something is going to happen. Has not happened yet. And then people are supposed to, Christians are supposed to be rich, but they are poor. That means something is going on in the realm of the spirit. So people, Christians are supposed to be, good things going on well, but it's not going on well. Something is happening in the realm of the spirit. So God is trying to invite you to begin to say certain things, to make things happen. Am I communicating?
Yes.
So don't take it ordinarily. Every Christian does not go through a normal process of things that's supposed to happen. That means something is, God is meaning for something somewhere. So God is expecting you to begin to put things in order and push things to happen. So God will not push it for you. Like you go to the hospital, you are pregnant. Donkey driver, come and push it for me. I'm ready to come out. Push my baby. No, you push it yourself. Doctor will not push it for you. You're going to push it yourself. What about this medical new disease where they put it and cut people's belly? But before, the woman will push. Push! They will say, push! Push! Or to push something out. Am I communicating? So God wants you and I to push something out. In the realm of the spirit, there is no, what do you call it? There is no such in the realm of the spirit. There is no such. Amen? Everything goes through normal process of pushing. You have to push. Amen? You have to push it out. So in the realm of the spirit, you are supposed to push. So God wanted Hannah to push, but she was not catching it. But the tenth year, the kingdom, the 10th year of the government of heaven, heaven decided to intervene by causing Penina to provoke, to cause God to do something.
Oh Jesus,
I see you getting there. Everything not working normal in your life, by the anointing of the Holy Ghost, everything that is misnomer, by the anointing of provocation, by the force of alignment, which is provocation, I declare you provoked. I command you to be provoked. I command you provoked. Be provoked in the spirit. Be provoked in the spirit. Be provoked in the spirit. In the name of Jesus. We are about to enter 3 days dry fast. And that time for provocation has come. As this spiritual realm trying to provoke your spirit. This 3 days fast, a time for me to say, God, I've been provoked. I've been provoked. I'm supposed to have this, I'm not having it. I've been provoked. It's time for me to cause things to happen. Cause change to happen. Change is coming your way. Change is coming your way. Change is coming your way. In the name of Jesus. Asabrakato. Let me fast because of time. Asole brakato shababaya. Provoker. Jesus. Verse 8. And Bible says, Elkanah. No, let me leave that one for now. Okay, let me say, verse 8. Can I, husband, why weepest thou and heart grieved? This man was going through serious trouble. Weeping, sobbing, like heart grieved, terribly in trouble, depressed. Am I not better than 10 sons? Because right now, the rival had 10 sons.
Okay.
Am I communicating?
Yes.
So that's why like I was saying, I know you are seeing 10 sons. Am I not better than 10 sons? She would have added 2 daughters, but not those days.
They can't believe me. Look at me. So, you know, man, this is Sunday. You know, Sunday is a very punk way, you know. Praise the Lord. How much better than 10 songs you are seeing from your friend now? I'm better. As long as I'm alive. Friends, can I give you a revelation? As long as the seed is alive, it's better than billions of dollars. Once the seed is alive and active, one day, monkey will go market. It will come back. It must produce. It will produce. As long as you are active and alive, even if it's not, don't worry, it will come one day. Just keep kabashing. Tell somebody, keep kabashing. Once God's word is alive in your spirit, you are still strong and dogged. You are coming to fellowship, praying, listen to God's word. You are always active in God's things. Don't worry. It might not come now. Very soon it will come. Because the seed is better than 10 songs. Better than millions of dollars. Once you have the seed, those things will come. They are called Jara. And my coming. Shout, my seed is alive. God's word is active and alive. In the name of Jesus. And so Hannah rose up. For the first time, ladies and gentlemen, the Bible now recognizes that Hannah was done playing games. Was done listening to depressions and mere words, idle words. She's now ready to handle the issues really. And the Bible says, and Hannah rose up. Friends, until you rise up, the seed that is waiting for you is not coming. Until you rise up, things will not come. Hannah rose, Bible says, in this place, rose up after the fall. And what happened? And prayed. For the first time, we are seeing verse 10 that Hannah prayed unto God. And she was wept, she wept so. Friends, time frame to talk about vow and then this that she made. Let me not go to the course of time so we can pray. Am I communication? Let me leave that for now. I want to leave us. Maybe time will come back there. Anyway, verse 12 says something that touched me. He says, and it came to pass as she continued praying.
Hallelujah.
Are you getting this?
Yes.
Are you getting this?
Yes.
Number one, verse 10 said she prayed. And verse 12 said, as she continued praying. Somebody asked me, Brother Mike, I've been praying. Where do I stop? As she continued praying, she continued. So engage yourself to continual prayer. Every month, do your daily fasting. Every month, day prayer. No, engage yourself continually. Don't stop. Tell somebody, don't stop. Continue praying. Before the Lord, and that Eli marked her out. Hey, do you hear that?
Yes.
The first time she prayed, Eli did not mark him out. But as she continued to pray, in the process of prayer, Eli marked it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Please, can you read Amplify for me in that place? Read Amplify for the version if you have it. Read 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 12.
Praise the Lord.
Okay, just amplify. Amplified, not any. I want amplified. Who has amplified version? Ashule bragada shaba. If you see before me, please open it. Jiba, mine is loading already. Loading. Quit trying to load. Zubrakatali bragado shikibaya. Zubrakatusa. Mayi bragado shakatali brigade. Yeah, you saw it. Amplified one.
Verse 12.
Yeah. Is amplified. Okay, read both amplified. Read the first one.
Okay, 12 says, now it happened as she continued praying before the Lord that Eli was watching her mouth. Hannah was speaking in her heart, mind. Only her lips were moving and her voice was not heard. So Eli was
watching her mouth. Bible says, marked her mouth. Read the second amplifier. There are two amplifiers there. The one at the house, listen. Shali Brapusa Kata. Okay, Maso Kata La Bragade Shavaya. Oh, even mine is having issues. Can't even access it now. Amen.
Shabragado Sakatala. Huh? Do you see, it? Verse 12. There are two amplified versions there. Do it. Hmm. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Se bragado sha bragade. Hmm. Her mouth. Her mouth. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hmm. Okay. Okay, fine. Now, the amplified version says this is what I'm looking for. In verse 12 says, and as she continued praying before the Lord, Eli noticed her mouth. Hey, Jesus, that's what I'm looking for. So that no one say mark, it's like a big English, but now you're going to say noticed. Does it mean, friends and gentlemen, that sometimes we come praying to God, God has not noticed us? Notice our mouth. Our mouth is moving. Does it mean? This one, this one, because you are not said, you are not said the right thing. You are still complaining. You are still grumbling. Oh God, my rival, my sister, my husband. He said this. He said that. Friends, can I say something very quickly here? That words are powerful. Words are very, very powerful. Let me tell you something, but you don't know. Words are very, very what powerful. Not just that, because listen to this very carefully. They produce what you call sounds. And listen very carefully. And sounds are vehicles of the spirit and angelic realm. I repeat. Sounds, listen very carefully, are vehicles for the spirit realm and the angelic realm. Why am I saying this? Bible says on the day of Pentecost, the Holy Ghost came as sound. Why did he come as sound? Do you notice that? Let me read that place. Acts chapter 2. Isn't it Acts chapter 2? Shah Bragada. Holy Ghost came as sound. Read that place for me so everybody can hear it. No, not 14. But it's verse 4. Is it verse 4? Hold on a second.
Okay, verse
4. Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And all of them were filled with the Holy Ghost.
Okay, no. But let's 2. Sorry. 2. I'm sorry. 2. Bible says here, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven. Suddenly, why did the Holy Ghost choose to come to sound, vehicle of sound? Because sounds are important. So, how do you produce sound? By voicing your words. When you voice your words, you produce sound. So, sound is a vehicle. It's a vehicle to produce, the vehicle for the spirit realm to walk and for the angelic being to walk. There are sounds. Without sound, the Bible says that Elijah can hear, could hear the sound of the abundance of rain. Only him could hear it because they are vehicle for transportation of the spirit realm. So when you talk, you produce sounds. So if you talk bad words, you produce sounds that we activate bad angels to work on it. If you talk good words, then you produce sound that will activate good angels to work with it. So whatever sound you produce produces energy. I'm not complicated. For example, I'm preaching the word now. I'm producing sound that is creating energy, spiritual energy, palatable and effective, ready made for the Holy Ghost to move. That's why you go to preach first before you pray. Holy Ghost to move because you are producing sound from God's word. You are preaching it. When you preach, you produce sound. It causes vibration in the realm of the spirit, and angels come to incubate. I'm not complicated. And the spirit realm come to incubate. So they all come because they fall into alignment. They're hearing God's word. God's word is powerful. God's word is God's voice. So sounds produce energy. And energy causes vibration in the realm of the spirit. And those realm of the spirit come down to incubate where there's a sound. So sound is very important. So you don't just say things anyhow. You can't just say, God, may God punish you. Oh, my child, this will happen to you. No, you're producing a wrong sound and causing a wrong vibration, creating wrong energy in person's life. So when the person gets to 20 years, he doesn't know why he's going to trouble. Because someone has spoken really wrong sound some time ago. And bad angels have gone to do something. Friends, words are powerful. Don't say things anyhow. Even when you're angry, sister, brother, don't say bad words to your husband, to your wife. Control yourself. I'm not going to get it. I know when we're angry. We're angry. We'll punish you. You are speaking bad words and you are creating negative environment, negative energies. And then demons like negative energies.
They come and inhabit the place that is a negative. That's why if you are speaking some negative, but you see, first people speaking wrong things. People talking rubbish. Like, there's negative already going around. So people are talking rubbish because there's negative, you know, effect, vibration everywhere. So the people are, people like it, demons like it, people, bad people like it, those who know God like it. So by doing that, you are not inviting demons, inviting negative angels, bad angels, because they feed from those words. They begin to work with it. And when they begin to work with it, it's not just now. They are only transgenerational. It does not stop it, also the fourth generation. It takes another Moses to cross, to debunk what you have said before. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Shabragaba. See what Jacob told about Reuben. Yes, I know you have the capacity to become strong. You're my strength, my first strength. But the way I'm seeing you, you're unstable as waters. And then that was his life. Until Moses came and undone it. So you need to have another prophet to do what you have said. To speak another sound. To counteract it. Am I communicating? So you don't just speak anyhow. So when Hannah was talking anyhow to the rival, hey, you said this, hey, why are you cursing me? Why are you insulting me? God said negative words. Wrong programming. So nothing happened. But when she came to Shiloh, began to speak and produce effective sound, Bible says God noticed it. Do you want God to notice you? Then speak the right words, produce the right energy. The heavens can notice you. Am I communicating? Most of us don't allow energy, our angels to work because you speak wrong words. Angels, good angels, your angels don't work with negative words, they work with powerful scriptural words. They notice it, they feed on it, and they work with it. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Shut up, we speak right. Nothing happened to Hannah until she started speaking right. Am I communicating?
Yes,
tonight, as you produce this sound effect from heaven, immortality will have immortality. Something will happen. No one that is just said, I can hear the sound of abundance of rain. Only him could hear it. The servant could not hear the sound at all. Why? Because it's a codes in the spirit. When you speak, you are coding something in the spirit. When the Holy Ghost comes, he codes in the form of sound. Only those who are in the spirit can hear it. When fire came upon Paul, Saul before becoming Paul, only him could hear it. But I'm going to, because it's a sound only meant for those whose ears are open. Friends, remember this. Bible says, if you, your words will condemn you or justify you. So what you say, you pay for it. You say idle words, you're going to pay for it. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Sound is a product of words, negative or positive.
Yes.
And when you produce it, depending, it creates energy, it creates vibration, and it depends who is there to walk. Am I communicating? So Hannah spoke positive sound. And God said, I've heard. If you go through the Hannah prayer, you see that you need to produce good energy. If you look, they don't read it by yourself. Let me finalize. Bible says she prayed, couldn't pray. Bible says God noticed it. God noticed it. Tonight I pray. God has noticed you. 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 In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. He said in verse 15, Hannah answered and said, no, my Lord, I'm a woman of sorrow spirit. I am provoked. It means sorrowful spirit means I'm provoked. Now, for the fourth time, we mentioned sorrowful spirits. Not much is provoked. She's vexed in the spirit. Not vexed in the kind of way, but vexed in the spirit. He said, I've drunk neither wine nor strong drink, but I have poured out my soul before the Lord. And Bible says, Jesus. After the whole conversion, verse 17, Eli answered and said, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant thee that petition that thou hast asked of him. And Bible says in verse 12, finally, and Bible says, verse 18, the Bible says, and she said, let the handmaid find grace in thy sight. So the woman went her way and did eat, and her countenance was no more sad.
Amen.
Power of prayer. Friends, if you are going through troubles and depression, go to prayer. When you finish praying, you're going to come out refreshed. Come out forgetting about what whatever I have said. She came out from there, not remembering a single thing her rival said. She came out no more sad. Friend, there's power in prayer. There's power in prayer. She came out refreshed, came out bouncing, came out hopeful, came back after. from that prayer point and say, look, my Samuel is coming. My Samuel is coming. My Samuel is coming. My Samuel is coming. I prophesy for you. After this prayer, your Samuel will arrive. Your Samuel will arrive. Your Samuel will arrive. Come on, jump on your feet. I see my Samuel delivered tonight. Open your mouth and fire prayer. I see my Samuel delivered today. I am pregnant with my Samuel. And my Samuel will deliver tonight. I will serve a living God. Who is the same yesterday, the same today, the same forevermore. If God had done it for Anna, it's your turn. It's your turn. It's your turn. Today you will conceive. Today you deliver. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh Lord, give me my Samuel. Oh, pull your mouth and fire prayer. Oh. Oh Lord, give me my Samuel. I am tired of these things. I am tired of my life. Pulling my life. Give me my Samuel. Give me that money. Give me that house. Give me my migration paper. Give me that, those children. Those well obedient children. Children that will obey the law. Children that will serve the Lord. Give me my children, oh, that will serve the law. Give me my children as prophets. Give them to me as prophets. Make them prophets of the land. Oh Lord, cause my children to become prophets of this world. Ah, yagada, lagada. Let my children start behaving well. Let my husband come to know you. Oh Lord, give me my Samuel, Lord. Oh, pull your mouth and fire prayer. You must deliver. I must deliver. My Samuel. In my children, in my husband, in my place of work, I must deliver. Very powerfully. Listen, and they rose in the morning and early and worshiped before the Lord and returned and came to their house to Ramah. Elkanah knew Hannah and his wife, and the Lord remembered her.
Amen.
Oh God, remember me. Oh, pull your mouth and fire prayer. Remember me, Lord. I've been through this for too long. I've suffered for too long. I've been through trouble for too long. Remember me, Lord. 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 I am tired of this level. I am tired of this level of life. Oh Lord, change my story.
Yeah.
what a handsome day, what a handsome day. In the name of Jesus. Listen, listen. Some of you are not praying. Some of you are looking at the gospel. Some of you are not praying. You are not looking around. May God deliver you in Jesus' name. You don't focus and concentrate. You're looking too much. You're looking here and there. Why are you looking too much? It's time to pray. When a woman is on a delivery bed, she doesn't look at her. She's focused. Focus in Jesus' name. Focus. Kalabaya. I welcome you to favor world. When you meet your force of alignment, when you be aligned with God and deliver your Samuel. This night I command you, deliver your Samuel. Deliver your Samuel. Deliver your Samuel. Deliver your Samuel. That delivers the Spirit of God. That delivers, delivers sound. As many of you honor the sound of God's word from my mouth, lift your hands. Lift your hands. As many of you honor the sound of God's word tonight, I command, let the heavens be open upon you. Let your miracle rush down to you. Oh my God. Bible said there was a rushing of this mighty wind. Let your miracle rush down to you now. Let your miracle be mighty in the land. Let your miracle come like a wind. Unpredictable. Unpredictable. Your prosperity, your progress, your restoration. Let it become mighty. Let it come rushing to you. Let it come rushing to you. Now. In the name of Jesus.
Friends,
in the name of Jesus, I need to finalize prayer with the scripture. Open your Bible to 12, book of Samuel. Sorry, book of John. Take your Bible. Book of John. Gospel of John, chapter 12, verse 29. I want to finalize this scripture, this prayer with this. Ah, my father. Ah, Shubragade. Hold on, let me get it. Ah, Zebragado. Chapter 12. Ah, Zubragada, Shegede. My father. Hey, look at verse 28. Glorify thy name. And look at verse 30. And Jesus answered. And the voice, Jesus answered and said, this voice. No, hold on, not a second. Verse 29. And the people, therefore, that stood by heard it. Let me go to verse 28 for proper understanding. Father, glorify thy name. Then came there a voice from where? Heaven. Saying, I have both glorified it and glorified it again.
Amen.
Hold that. Verse 29. And the people, look at it. People who are mortal, so don't understand this to the spirit. They said in verse 30, and people, therefore, stood by, heard it. And said he thundered. You see that? The mortal men, they say he thundered. That's what they see. Physical things, they thundered. And others said angels spoke to him. You see that? But Bible says in verse 13, and Jesus answered and said, this voice came not because of me, but for your sake.
Amen.
And what did the voice say? Verse 31. Now is the judgment of the world. Now is judgment of this world. Now shall the prince of this world be cast out.
Hallelujah.
That was what the voice said. The voice produced God's word to announce his son about to go to Calvary. But mere men heard thunder, and a man of immortality heard sound. Friends, only those who are in the spirit can hear sound from heaven. Mortal men will hear thunder and lightning.
Amen.
Oh God, open my ears. Ah, friends, we are looking for precision, accuracy. My ears to hear you speak to me. The ears of my heart, the ears of my spirit, cause me to hear you. Ah, sound from heaven. Thank you, precious Father. I prophesy for you. From today, I command your hearing spirit to open. When you read the Bible, you will hear something from heaven.
Yes,
something that your neighbor might not hear.
Yes.
Even your husband, your wife might not even hear. Amen. It will bellow. And you hear God just spoke to me now.
Amen.
I command your ears to open.
Amen.
I command sound to come from heaven.
Amen.
Bringing down the coding of the spirit unto
Amen.
You. To produce result. This week you prosper.
Amen.
This week you profit.
Amen.
All the days of your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Those of you on the line, if you are sick, please put your left hand wherever you are feeling sick. If you are sick, put your left hand there. Your waist, your head, put your left hand there and lift up your right hand to Jesus. I don't know, my time is up. No, time is an enemy in the realm of the spirit.
Yes.
You foul spirit, call infirmity, sickness, I rebuke you.
Yes, Lord.
And if there be any curse over your life, I curse that curse.
Yes, Lord.
If there be any foundation working against your destiny, I curse that foundation.
Amen.
Now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For the crown of your head, to the sole of your feet,
yes,
I curse every sickness, every pain, every disease working against you. I curse it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
By the sound of God's word, you pain, I command you, come out in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Sickness, come out in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Everything that has not pleased God in your life, I command you to die now. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I command you be delivered.
Amen.
Be restored.
Amen.
Be made whole. Receive your Samuel. Receive your Samuel. Every failure in your life, I turn to success. Now,
amen.
Name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every pain and sorrow you are going through, I turn to prosperity. Now, in the name of Jesus.
Receive Jesus' name. Amen.
Today, you don't know sorrow anymore.
Amen.
No more sorrow. No more backwardness.
Amen.
For whatever in your life,
amen,
you and your family members,
amen,
in the name of Jesus,
amen,
your womb is blessed.
Yes,
your womb is blessed. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, precious Father.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Every prayer you have made, you have been making, trusting God for delivery now. Receive your miracles.
I receive it.
Receive your miracles.
I receive.
Receive your miracles.
I receive.
Receive your miracles.
I receive it.
Go, you're free.
Amen.
Go, you're free.
Amen.
Go, you're free.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Your open womb.
Yes.
And open mouth.
Yes, Lord.
Before it was closed womb, open mouth. But now both are open.
Yes.
I shall both of them are open. Come on, clap for Jesus.
Yes.
Every person, you have open wombs.
Yes.
You have open mouth.
Yes.
Go and take your Samuel.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. What an awesome word from the Lord. Just begin to clap for the Lord.